हेलो क्लास 12, वेलकम बैक टू आवर चैनल शिक्षक जंक्शन, क्योंकि अब नहीं तो कब। दिस इज आयुषी अग्रवाल एंड वी आर डीलिंग आवर चैप्टर ऑन ह्यूमन रिप्रोडक्शन। बाय नाउ व्हाट वी हैव डन इज वी हैव कंप्लीटेड आवर स्पर्मेटोजेनेसिस पार्ट, दैट इज द डेवलपमेंट ऑफ द मेल गैमेट स्पर्म्स। नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट दिस ओजेनेसिस, दैट इज the development or the formation of the mature female gamete, that is how you define this oogenesis part, hai na? I think that by now you are very much familiar with the symbols of the male and female that I am using regularly in my lectures, right? So oogenesis is the development of mature female gamete. Now, an interesting part about this oogenesis is it starts at the embryonic developmental stage. See, I am just marking or highlighting in the figure itself so that you might not forget. Okay, so this oogenesis part starts during the embryonic developmental stage. Now, what happened during this embryonic development, that is even more interesting to understand. Okay, during this development stage or even during the birth of a baby, millions of gamete mother cells starts to develop. What it is? Gamete mother cells. See, if somewhere the writing is not visible to you, I am repeating it or I am saying it that so that you might not be confused. Okay, digitalized writing and the writing on the board is a little bit different. So you might encounter at some places that it is not clearly visible what it is written. For that, you have to visit the video or you have to see the video to the fullest. You cannot skip in order to avoid the conflictions within the lecture. Okay, so these gamete mother cells, what are they known as? They are known as this oogonium. See, from the figure, the very first thing is this primordial germ cell. It undergoes several mitotic divisions. Again, mitotic divisions it has encountered, that means the ploidy level remains the same, it remains the 2n. So this becomes the oogonium and this development takes place within the embryo. Okay, so after the or no more oogonia, you can also say it like this, that no, when gamete mother cells leads to the formation of what it is known as the oogonia. The singular of oogonia is what it is written in the figure, that is oogonium. Okay, within each fetal ovary, now no more oogonia are added after the birth. That means whatever are left within the fetal stage are those that carry on during the whole life of a female, right? So no more oogonia are going to be formed or added after the birth. These cells, what happens? These cells start division. See, again you have this mitotic divisions. Okay, so these cells start dividing and they till the birth stage, see up till here, up till the gray portion is over from the figure, it is in the embryo and this happens after the birth. So before the birth happens or at the time of birth, it leads to the formation of what it is known as the primary oocyte. Okay, I'll write down after the embryonic development. Up till the birth, what happens is it leads to the formation of what it is known as the primary oocyte. Okay. Now this primary oocyte has again a special feature associated with is what it is. The primary oocyte is arrested or when this oogonia has started division within the fetal stage, the particular dividing stage at which this primary oocyte halts is the prophase 1 of the meiotic division. Prophase of meiosis 1. This we all know that prophase is one of the phase of the meiosis 1. So that is what it is written here. At the birth, this primary oocytes are present and special feature of these primary oocytes are or is it they are arrested at the prophase of the meiosis 1 stage. Now after the birth or at the age of puberty, what happens? Further divisions takes place and this secondary oocyte gets formed. Now जितना सिंपल यहाँ फिगर से दिख रहा है उतना इजी नहीं है प्राइमरी ऊसाइट से सेकेंडरी ऊसाइट में कन्वर्जन। देयर आर लॉट मेनी स्टेजेस दैट अ ऊसाइट एनकाउंटर्स व्हेन इट लीड्स टू द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ प्राइमरी ऊसाइट और द सेकेंडरी ऊसाइट फ्रॉम द प्राइमरी ऊसाइट। नाउ व्हाट आर दीज चेंजेस दैट वी विल स्टडी फ्रॉम अ सेपरेट फिगर। आई विल गेट बैक टू दिस फिगर व्हेन आई विल मेक यू एक्सप्लेन अबाउट दिस पर्टिकुलर प्रोसेस। ओके, जब हम सेकेंडरी ऊसाइट पर आएंगे तब वापस से इसी फिगर को कंटिन्यू करेंगे अपना जो है अरेस्टेड एट द मेटाफेज ऑफ द मियोसिस टू। ये यहाँ से प्राइमरी ऊसाइट से सेकेंडरी ऊसाइट तक का कन्वर्जन कैसे हुआ पहले हम वो देखेंगे एंड दैट टू फ्रॉम अ सेपरेट फिगर। क्लियर? इस फिगर पे मैं वापस आने वाली हूँ तो जस्ट रिमेंबर दिस पर्टिकुलर फिगर। सो दिस इज द पर्टिकुलर फिगर फ्रॉम विच और फ्रॉम वेयर वी आर गोइंग टू अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट हैपेंस ड्यूरिंग द डेवलपमेंट फ्रॉम द प्राइमरी ऊसाइट टू द सेकेंडरी ऊसाइट। ठीक, देखो सबसे पहले क्या हुआ, जब प्राइमरी ऊसाइट बना या फिर जो हमारा प्राइमरी ऊसाइट था दैट बिकम्स सराउंडेड बाय लॉट मेनी लेयर्स ऑफ ग्रैन्यूलोसा सेल्स एंड व्हाट इट लीड्स टू द फॉर्मेशन, इट लीड्स टू द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ स्ट्रक्चर दैट इज नोन एज दिस प्राइमरी फॉलिकल। दिस प्रिमोर्डियल फॉलिकल इज व्हेन द प्राइमरी ऊसाइट स्टार्ट्स गेटिंग सराउंडेड बाय सर्टेन लेयर्स एंड व्हाट दीज लेयर्स आर ऑफ, दीज लेयर्स आर ऑफ दीज ग्रैन्यूलोसा सेल्स। राइट, सो आई विल जस्ट राइट डाउन हाउ इट गोज ऑन। सी, यू हैव द प्राइमरी फॉलिकल। ओके, this primary follicle gets surrounded by very many layers of the granulosa cells and it leads to the formation of what it is known as the primary, okay sorry, this prime, it is not the primary follicle here, I have written it by mistake, let me erase this first and then I'll write down what it is. Okay, this is not primary follicle, it is the primary oocyte, that is what we have talked about, hai na? Just to make me remind, okay, how can you remind, obviously in the comment section, hai na? That means that you are present in the lecture. Okay, so this is primary oocyte, when it gets surrounded by the granulosa cells, what it forms, it leads to the formation of the primary follicle. You can clearly see from the figure what actually it means. See, there are lot many layers that are getting surrounded. It oocyte is within the inside and then this granulosa cells starts forming the layer. After this primary follicle is formed, what happens are is after this stage of development, lot many follicles degenerate during the phase from birth up till birth, actually they degenerate. Okay, lot many follicles degenerate from the birth up till puberty and at the time of puberty approximately 60,000 to 80,000 remains within each ovary. Okay, so within each ovary up till the puberty, the number of primary follicle that remains is the 60,000 to 80,000. Now, what happens? This primary follicle again starts to develop few more granulosa cells and then what it actually forms? It forms this secondary follicle. See, when primary follicle adds up many layers like zona pellucida, this granulosa cells, the cica cells, theca cells, what it actually forms? It forms the secondary follicle. Now again, some more developmental stages happen during this secondary follicle stage and our follicle matures few more or develops further and it leads to the formation of what it is known as the tertiary follicle. And how you identify this tertiary follicle? You have another criteria to characterize this tertiary follicle. What it is that we will talk about. Okay, so I'll repeat, this primary follicle degenerate to 60,000 to 80,000 in number and then What is formed is the secondary follicle. Now, further more changes happens into the secondary follicle, which leads to the formation of this tertiary follicle. Now, how we will characterize that the structure that has been formed gives rise to the tertiary follicle? So, this tertiary follicle gets characterized by a fluid filled cavity that is known as this antrum. You can clearly see the antrum from this figure. The secondary follicle contains this fluid filled cavity within it that is known as antrum, and after the development of this antrum, or when this primary oocyte contains this secondary follicle or tertiary follicle into it, it completes its first meiotic division. This is also very important. Again, I am repeating it again so that you might not be confused of what is happening. See, when the primary follicle gets into the secondary follicle, a fluid filled cavity gets into it, and that is known as this antrum. I know it is a little bit complicated part to make you understand, but yes, I am sure that you will understand that, and if not, you have the comment section to clear your doubts. Okay, so what happens, this tertiary follicle or the secondary follicle, when develop this antrum into it, it is known as the tertiary follicle. I am writing it here so that you might be clear from this particular thing, right? So this tertiary follicle grows inside, and then it leads to the completion of the first meiotic division. We have studied from the previous figure that prophase 1, up to the prophase 1, this particular stage has been arrested, right? So it leads to the formation of tertiary follicle, and by now this first meiotic division is complete. Now, going back to the previous figure that we have seen, let me show you that particular figure. Now see what happens is with this figure. Just understand what is there written in the figure. Okay, now I have told you that completion of this meiosis 1 happens when the tertiary follicle grows inside this, that is the cavity filled, and onset of meiosis 2 occurs. This is also important, right? After the onset of, or after the completion of this meiosis 1, what happens is an unequal division leads to the formation of this first polar body, and again a larger structure that is known as the secondary oocyte. Right, unequal division happens when the completion of meiosis 1 takes place, and it leads to the formation of a structure that is known as the secondary oocyte and tiny first polar body. Right, now this secondary oocyte, which is present here, it contains or it retains the nutrients that are there within the primary oocyte. Now I am writing primary this way, but obviously you cannot write it in this way in your examination, so you have to be very clear about this particular point. Okay, so this primary oocyte or the secondary oocyte contains the cytoplasm that is rich or of, it is of that primary oocyte, and then it leads to the formation of what it is known as the tertiary follicle. Now again we will go back to our figure from where we are getting the idea of what are the changes that takes place. Okay, so now coming on to the tertiary follicle stage, let me just make you again with this figure now. Okay, yes, now this tertiary follicle, we will talk about this tertiary follicle again. This tertiary follicle further enlarges to form, or further enlarges to give you the structure that is known as the mature follicle, or that is known as the Graafian follicle. Okay, Graafian follicle is very apt from the figure. See, it contains a very large fluid filled cavity known as antrum. It contains oocyte, it contains the corona radiata, that is the outermost layer that you can say. It contains the oocyte and a large fluid filled cavity that is known as the antrum. Now, secondary oocyte also forms a new membrane that is known as the zona pellucida layer. How the zona pellucida layer is important, that we will talk about in our upcoming lectures, but you must remember the name of the zona pellucida ki we have discussed at some particular point of time. Now this secondary or this graafian follicle now leads to the release of this oocyte or the secondary oocyte, you can also say it as secondary oocyte or the ovum from the ovary. And this particular process, when the graafian follicle releases the secondary oocyte, it is known as the ovulation. This is how the complete process of oogenesis takes place. Okay, from the figure also, from the previous figure, if I'll just show you again. So this is the ovulation part that you might see from the figure. See, the ovulation is when the secondary oocyte or the ovum leads to or exits the secondary oocyte. See, this is the secondary oocyte. No, ovulation happens. This is the ovum part. Okay. So this is how the complete process of oogenesis takes place. I hope that it is very clear to you. If not, I am there to make you clear. Okay, but for that you have to obviously mention your doubts in the comment section or into the Gmail ID. Clear? I know that it is a little bit complicated portion because you have to just correlate with the two figures, but I have made you the best possible way to explain from the figures itself. देखो जो representation का तरीका होता है, ये जो figures होता है, उसे याद करना थोड़ा easy रह जाता है, क्योंकि pictorial representation is always the best part, and that is why we have chosen this digitized mode. So I hope that you all are enjoying this, and do like and share the content if you find it up to the mark. And also subscribe the channel for such more interesting updates, right? Take care till then. Have a good day, all of you. Bye-bye. That's all for this lecture. We will meet in our next lecture with, yes, a very important topic that will cue this particular points, whatever we have discussed. Okay? So, bye-bye. Thank you.